Mesa, and you're watching Hollywire.
You ready to play the spinny game? Dating. Dating deal breaker. Are you dating anyone right now?
No. Dude, I have no idea. If they say like, oh, who's Deadmau5, they're like,
if they're so bad music taste.
Naive.
Instagram or TikTok?
Instagram.
What? No. Really? Did you like blow up on TikTok?
Instagram 10 times out of 10.
Instagram? Do you make personal TikToks?
Yeah.
You just don't enjoy it very much?
I enjoy it. It's cool. Okay.
Would you rather be invisible or be able to fly?
I could do so much if I could fly.
Time is... Do you like to travel?
I've never traveled.
What's like your dream destination? Like number one place you'd want to go?
Okay, I know, so intrigued by locations that are exotic and you know, cultures that are just truly like no other. And so for that, I'm really like, I'm sure like somewhere off the coast of like Iceland, there's a hut and you'll meet a really wise man who will offer you like a flask and like just some like very.
I feel like I've asked a lot of people that question in my lifetime. I've never heard that answer. Did you just move to LA?
Yeah, well, okay, so I moved here like a year and 3 months ago. Okay. But I just got into this like newer place like 12 days ago.
I'm pretty sure like everyone has heard this song. It was ILY and then it switched to I Love You Baby Now officially.
Yeah, okay. So that was like a recommendation from someone I work really close with. He was like, you know, people hear this song and in the song they hear like I Love You Baby, but like they're not gonna type in like ILY. And so
so
I guess like we made like this 400 IQ play to like switch the song.
When you first made the song, were you expecting that at all? Or was it like it just blew up and like you didn't see it coming?
Basically the story of like how the song came about was I was actually sitting in the Starbucks parking lot. I was on TikTok and I came across a video made by an artist named Emily, who's all together. We've become like pretty close to this point. And that's where the raw vocals came from. And so it was just her in her bedroom like covering the song, and I was like, wow, like this is an amazing take on it. She sounds like super good.
Your tracks are like upbeat and like happy, kind of. Was that your kind of creative direction with that?
Yeah, that song. I think it's easy to capture that kind of vibe to it. I would like make this music, and I didn't like have any featured singers, but I would go on like online and get like, I don't know, samples of like vocals. And then like pitch them all weird, do these effects, and like make these electronic beats and put them on SoundCloud.
Do you have any like other like DJs or artists that you really look up to?
I'll always look up to Deadmau5 because of how like, well there's a lot more, but Deadmau5 I can get into because you can just tell he really mastered his craft. He knows everything about what he's doing.
Have you played live before? Have you been to a festival? Have you...
Like really low key. Okay, I've never been to a festival. I've never...
Ever?
No. Like I've...
You're about to play at them. What do you mean you've never been to one?
Experience at a festival will be like playing.
Yeah. I saw that you tweeted a few days ago that you were in the studio with an idol. Do you have any super exciting collabs coming up? Can you talk about it at all?
The most surreal thing in my life. It was like an 8-hour session with myself and this other individual who is set in stone in the game. I don't want to say anything. I don't want to have this track pulled.
Okay, beautiful. Thank you so much.
All right, y'all. Thank you so much.
Bye. Okay.